Hello everyone, welcome you all for the Startup Story series. My name is Guna, I'm a startup coach and the author of the book Startup Recipe. In this episode, we have a very special person, one of my good friends, Mr. Srinivasagiri, founder of Arogya Siri Ayurvedic Therapy Center, where illness, wellness and beauty treatments are done. He has got rich experience of last 30 years in sales and business development in four different industries: agriculture, Ayurveda, organic foods, and also in finance. So he is going to share a lot with us today about his entrepreneur journey, and he is going to help us understand how an aspiring entrepreneur can start a business and what kind of things they should keep in mind, etc. So welcome to the show, Mr. Srinivasagiri.
Hi Guna, and hello everyone. Greetings from Arogya Siri.
Thank you for joining us this show to inspire aspiring entrepreneurs. I'm doing this series called Startup Stories because there are a lot of aspiring entrepreneurs now. They want to understand what is right, what is wrong when they start a business, and this series is helping them in many ways by just getting a lot of takeaways from various successful entrepreneurs like you. So thank you for joining us for this show. So you have decided to move from a corporate background to an entrepreneurship. You were initially in the corporate background, then you moved to entrepreneurship. Can you tell us what made you to decide to jump from corporate world to the entrepreneur world?
Okay, it's a long story, Aguna. It's almost like it took me about 20 years of corporate life, and then, you know, then I moved to life of my own. But I will tell you, but the journey started after I completed about 15 years of my career. Okay. Suddenly, when I look back, that was in the mid-30s of my age, you know, suddenly, okay. I look back, you know, there was a good amount of health which I had lost. That was in the daily routine, in your lifestyle, your new lifestyle, and the stressful life. I lost good amount of health. When I say that, it is typically, you are also a victim, you're also discovered as a diabetic, you have hypertension, and you know, your lungs, you don't have a great breathing ability, all this because of the lifestyle, the city life. Now this made me think, and it nearly took another 4 to 5 years to discover and find how you can actually regain. That is where, you know, I came into the concept of, you know, how do I gain my age back? That is what made me to think, and then more of corporate life and start your own life.
So this made you to come up with something like Arogya Siri so that it can help many such people like you who are facing this issue, right?
Absolutely. Here, what the thing is, you know, what I lost was basically health, and how do I gain back? The gaining back is where we started thinking about food and Ayurveda. You know, Ayurvedic lifestyle. When I say Ayurveda, it is Ayurvedic lifestyle. And food is very much part and parcel of this. This is what we started to understand, how ancient Indians are traditionally, they lived. Traditionally, we all lived. When I just look back to the generations, I understand their lifestyle. I try to understand. And, you know, it was not an easy journey. We had to implement a lot of things. So we did do that. First thing I did was to move away from the metro city and started to live in a smaller city like Mysore. That helped me first, where I was assured of good water and air. Then, you know, our activities, the lifestyle involved food production, which is farming. We did hardcore farming as well as, you know, because my belief was in Ayurveda, I took help of one of the best consultants in the industry. And it helped me to start this Ayurvedic therapy center called Arogya Siri in the year 2013. And it's been 7 years from there on. And thank God, we are doing well. We are one among the best in Mysore.
Okay. So can you just share a little bit more about how was the journey of Arogya Siri and like the last few years, like how it is going on after you started?
Yes, actually, you know, I hardly had any business background, you know, basically, you know, zero business background, but had a rich corporate experience, you know, even a consistent growth in corporate life. And then I moved to this business. It took us some time. It took us some time, you know, the mindsets and mind shifts.
Okay.
And I'm talking to you, like, you know, I involved my family also into this. My wife helps me in this. My daughter is also part of it now. And you know, we all are making this, we just definitely want it to be a most respected Ayurvedic Therapy Center in Mysore. And we are there. We have been rated one of the best, as I mentioned earlier.
Superb. And dear viewers, if you're going to Mysore, don't miss to go to this Ayurvedic Therapy Center, and it is a superb experience which you should definitely take wherever you go to Mysore. And you said you have got family into the business. Yeah, I also know about it. Your spouse and your daughter is already involved in the business. Generally, when somebody starts a business or when they are doing business already, it is not easy thing to bring family members into the business and to make them come in the same wavelength, same frequency with the vision of the company. And also, we should balance work and home without any hassle. So, it is not something easy to do. And many aspiring entrepreneurs, maybe they want to involve their family members into business. If you can share how you managed it, how you had your set of some guidelines within yourself, within the family, though that this is business, this is our family relationship, this is how we have to do, we all have to do this work, the accountability. There may be a lot of things. So can you just share how you made it so that it will help others also?
Oh God, a very sensitive question you have picked, Guna. I know there can be a lot of pros and cons, but honestly, you're right. It's not an easy decision to involve your family. Not just one person, now the second person also. It is definitely not an easy decision. Yeah. I totally agree. But here I'll tell you, it is not, we didn't come together because it was a very enterprising business or something. What happened, my wife also had a very successful career in Bangalore. While I was in a financial market, she also had her own successful career. But we both understood the need for health and need to recover from wherever we are. You know, as the age catches up, you know, slightly overweight, obesity, and you start seeing that, you know, I'm not that good anymore. This was common between us. So the way we came together was basically as the concept for health. So that is where, you know, we both started involving. She was very much part of whatever we did in organic food production. She was very much part of it because she was the one who was helping me to make end products. I was into production and she was into making it an end production. And even when we started Ayurvedic Therapy Center, it was quite obvious that we are together. Initially, the first few years, I ran it hands-on there. And later on, I only looked at business development, and she takes care of operations. That's how. I don't interfere in day-to-day operations, and that's how we have actually distributed our work. And recently, I had my daughter also joining in the last year and a half, and she also takes care of business development. That's how we are able to bring people together and use this. But I don't advise this ad hoc to everyone, with caution.
Okay. So kudos to you to manage within a family, both business and family together. That's a superb thing which we got. You gave some insights on that. And you were in the corporate world and you moved to business world, which is two different things. And when you started this business of Aarogya Siri, what were the challenges you had initially?
I must tell you, definitely there were a lot of challenges. First of all, we do not have that entrepreneur mindset. I'll tell you one thing I have, only two things I had in common, like dealing with customers, that is customer service and accountability. Yes, it's common even as an employee I had and even as an entrepreneur. But that entrepreneurship mindset is not there. Sometimes I would say in terms of decision making, some of the things, these things, you know, we're not really good at. We don't, I'll tell you, they say for miles, what I see, look back, there is no one doing business in our family. Traditionally, we all have been employed. It was a tough decision. We learned it over a period of time. We learned it, you know, fortunately what I did, you know, I did a good amount of networking in Mysore. This helped me to see a lot of business owners. I was able to take their help. I was really able to take their help and understand that part. And I had a lot of peers to learn from.
Super. So you started without anyone in the business background from the family, but you had a lot of friends around from whom you started learning and overcoming these challenges. That's again a good value to audience, because most of my interviews, you know, when people say first-time entrepreneurs, first-generation entrepreneurs, then obviously it is going to add a lot of value to people who are watching this, because those who want to start a business always thinking that my family, nobody is into business. Can I do a business? Can I come into business? Everybody thinks like, if I, my father is already into business, I can come, but nobody is there in my family. How can I start? This question is there with everybody. So I think this, your story about you're a first generation entrepreneur answers that question as well. Super. Thank you for that. And what are the mistakes you did as a newcomer, as a new entrepreneur? What were the mistakes you did?
Okay, that's another interesting question. So first of all, let me tell you that, you know, while you are in a corporate career, while you are growing in a corporate career, you have a very aggressive path. I definitely had a very aggressive path. I came from an aggressive background because I come from a business development background. When I started this business, we started seeing some success in the early days. And I really took this success in a way, and you know, I started expanding. I took up expansion. Now, 7 years down the line, when I look, I know that was actually one of the big mistakes which I did. We wanted to even grow, give, you know, develop our market into franchising. Those two, expansion and franchising model, didn't work the way we wanted to work. That, when I look back now, I see those two were mistakes. It did, you know, hinder our growth. First is to settle down, establish your mother branch, you know, work for a good number of time, and then, you know, you look for expansion. Maybe probably because of my background, I did it early, and I can tell you that was one of the biggest mistakes I've done.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for sharing that. And entrepreneurs sharing their own mistakes is not something a normal thing, like sometimes only if it is going to help others, so only those who want to inspire others will tell this. Thank you for sharing that. Don't branch out or don't look for expansion. Just stick to one branch and then establish and then just branch it out. Super. That's a super value which you have given. And you have got some 30 years of experience, including your corporate experience in various industries like agriculture, organic foods, Ayurveda, finance, etc. With all this experience put together and your entrepreneurial experience also, what kind of suggestions or tips you want to give to someone who is going to start their entrepreneurial career right now? Because they have a lot of questions in mind and they want to start. So if you have to give as a successful entrepreneur, what will be your suggestion and tips to them?
Amazing question. Good question, Guna. Well, you know, whenever you conceive any business, whenever you are conceiving or, you know, when you want to start your business, the first thing is, you know, what problem are you solving or what way you are actually adding value to customers like? This is what I in a simple word, I call it relevance. What is your relevance in the industry? If you're not able to add value, if you're not adding value, customers will definitely reject you. Is there a problem which you're trying to solve? And that is where, you know, your relevance comes into the picture. So dig deeper and please understand, you know, how much of value you're able to add to the customer or to the society. Only then, you know, your business, actually your success stands there, is what I can tell from whatever number of years I have learned in this industry.
Okay, super. So I think this short interview gave a lot of information, a lot of takeaways for all those who are watching. So before we close this short interview, is there anything else you want to share for the aspiring entrepreneurs? People who want to start their business, who have some thoughts, along with that, they have some fears. So something is stopping them, but they want to start a business. So is there anything you want to tell before we close this session?
Okay. Gunnar, you rightly mentioned, you know, it's about entrepreneurship is a mindset. Basically, it's a mindset. As you were talking, you know, not necessarily, you know, your father, your forefathers, or, you know, somebody would have been an entrepreneur. That is not necessary. The risk is there. Actually, what I'm trying to say is, you know, you're more worried about the society. You're more worried about the society around you. I know you're socially responsible, but it is always important that, you know, we get sufficient education. We get sufficient education, sufficient exposure. One should always aspire to be an entrepreneur and always, you know, giving an opportunity, creating a lot of employment. It's not sin to be employed, I'm saying, but it is always great. It is always great, you know, if you can have that entrepreneur mindset and support the cause. You can create more jobs. It's definitely worth all the risk you take in life.
Definitely. Thank you. Thank you very much for all that insights you gave from your entrepreneurial journey. I'm sure a lot of people are going to start business and they are going to create more jobs for more people. So thank you very much for joining for this interview in the Startup Story series. Thank you. Thank you, Srinivas, sir.
Thank you so much. And really, thank you. It was my honor, Guna, for inviting me today. I had a nice time. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone watching this video. Kindly share this video because these insights may be useful for more aspiring entrepreneurs out there so that they can come out and they can start their entrepreneurship. So please share to as many people as possible. Thank you very much for watching today's interview in this Startup Stories. I will come up with one other success story, one other entrepreneur to share their insights in shortly. See you in the next video. Thank you very much.